Making its original debut in 1984, the once-known Dutch Torwangen Meisterschaft was Germany's most prominent racing series in Europe, bringing with it car manufacturers such as Mercedes-Benz, Audi, Opel, Alfa Romeo, and BMW. The series went under in 1996 due to costs. However, in 2000, the series was reborn under the title DTM. With 2010 coming to a close and it's heralding 10 years of German racing, the Forza 3 Regional Championship Series is looking to make its mark in this. We will also see not only Audi and Mercedes, but the return of Opel. With a total of 5 races spanning 4 countries across Europe, it'll bring these drivers from Italy's Mugello Club Circuit to the Nürburgring in Germany. And only one of these drivers will be the victor.
Keep it slow, keep it slow. Got a car here inside, inside. Keep it slow, keep it slow.
Good afternoon, race fans, and welcome to the Forza 3 Regional Championship Series. Today, we're doing the Dutch Touring Masters. I'm your announcer, KRX, and we're coming to you live from Florence, Italy at the Mugello Circuit. It's about 61 degrees and partly cloudy. Today with me is none other than Shibby5777, a normal racer in the tournament. However, he's not entering today. How's it going, Shib?
Very good to be here. Fortunately, due to other circumstances, we are unable to race my team today. But be glad to be up here in the booth.
And can you elaborate on what type of problems you had with, I believe it was your Mercedes, correct?
Yes, that is correct. We were having engine problems earlier, calibrating everything, but fortunately we're not able to be there today.
And looking at today's statistics, it looks like the top contenders today are Dejected Racer and Fallen 215. Dejected Racer has currently 3 tournaments underneath this belt. That would be the Cobalt, the Skyline, and I believe there was another one which I cannot think of right now. And Fallen 215 currently has 1 championship underneath this belt. Now, between those 2 competitors, do you think Dejected Racer is going to come home with a 4th, or is it going to be Fallen 215?
Well, Dejected Racer here is obviously going to be the winner, but anything can happen in these races, so we'll have to see.
All right, while we get ourselves set up for today's race, let's take a look at the track and the starting lineup presented by Tag Heuer.
The Mugello Club Circuit is a 1.79-mile road course. It is consisted of 8 turns and is part of the Mugello Full Circuit. The drivers will experience increase and decrease in elevations as they enter each turn. From the starting finish line, the drivers will make their way upwards to turn 1, which is called San Donato. The one concern about turn 1 is the drivers will have to slow down and predict where they're going to have to enter the turns. One miscalculation and they will go right into the gravel trap. From turn 1, they'll make a slight right-hander up to turn 2, Luco. Luco is the first of the S turns and is required to be shifted down to 3rd to 4th gear. They will make their way through turn 3, which is Piggio Seco. From there will be a slight increase in elevation and slight downcrease towards turn 4, Materassi. From there, they'll go through the last S turn to turn 5, known as Borgo San Lorenzo. There will be one more increase and decrease in elevation until they hit turn 6, Casanova, and then a slight right-hander towards turn 7, Savelli. From there, they'll make one more right-hander at turn 8 and come right back to the start-finish line. And that is the Mugello Club Circuit. Today's starting lineup of the Dutch Touring Masters is sponsored by luxury Swiss watchmaker Tag Heuer. Tag Heuer, what are you made of? Starting with row 1, on the pole, we have Dejected Racer. Currently with 3 championships underneath his belt, he's looking forward to making the Dutch Touring Masters his 4th. And right next to Dejected Racer is X-Unit. Currently a rookie who always starts good, but always finishes last. Let's see how he does from second place. And in row 2, we have Fallen 215. Fallen 215 has won the full circuit in the Subaru vs. Mitsubishi tournament, and also won that championship. Fallen 215 did really good in practice today, so let's see how he does starting from 3rd. And right next to Fallen 215 is Zeta 0085. Zeta 0085 started on the pole in the full circuit during the Subaru vs. Mitsubishi tournament. Let's see if his chances are very good today. And starting in the third row, we have Natty Ice 60. Natty Ice 60 starts his second tournament, and right next to Natty Ice 60 in last place is Quicksilver X21.
Alright, the cars are out in the field, and they're getting ready to get for the green light in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Green light's out, and here they go on the straightaway at Mugello. Dejected Racer gets a good launch for first place.
Beautiful day for racing.
On board with our new rooftop cam, Zeta-85 in fourth place coming up to turn 1.
Let's see what happens here.
And we have some contact between X-Unit and...
Looks like it seems Natty Ice.
Natty Ice 60. And another contact between Quicksilver and Natty Ice again?
Seems he can't control himself today.
Well, this puts X-Unit in third place, but let's take a look at what happened between both X-Unit and Natty Ice. Alright, Chip, can you give us a run-by-run playthrough of what happened?
Seems like Natty Ice didn't have enough time to brake, and he rammed right into X-Unit.
As we can see, both cars go right into the gravel trap. Alright, let's take a look again from our aerial footage provided by Mitsubishi. Natty Ice is the pink car, and X-Unit is the black and silver car, and Zeta is the orange car. Alright, slowing down the camera here, it looks like Natty Ice did not have enough time to brake and clipped into X-Unit's right side.
Seems like they both flew off track.
And there was also another contact between, looks like, Quicksilver and Zeta. It looks like Quicksilver hit Zeta, but I can't really tell from here.
Seems like a small tap, but changes to something big.
And here comes Natty Ice, who rams right into the back of Quicksilver.
Looked a little intentional, but can't sail from here.
Right. Okay, well, let's try to get another viewpoint, this time from Natty Ice 60. He swerves by Zeta, slowing down the camera. Hits him pretty hard that he manages to wobble the in-car camera.
Looks like he had no time to dodge Quicksilver as he was coming out.
Well, hopefully. I know those two drivers have a little bit of a bad history on the field. Alright, swapping the leadership around, we're now at lap 3. Oh, on board with Quicksilver is currently in last place, and right in front of him is Natty Ice 60.
And off the tracks again.
Alright, the swap positions change. It looks like now Quicksilver's in 4th, Zeta's in 5th, and Natty Ice 60 is in last place. Meanwhile, back up in the front of the field, well, guess who we see up in the front? Fallen 215 Dejected Racer.
Not surprised to see both of these guys up here.
No, and Dejected Racer known for having 3 championships currently underneath his title, and Fallen 215 with 1. On board with Dejected Racer. Now, from your experience racing against Dejected Racer, how do you feel he does as a driver?
He's a good, clean racer, respects everyone else, probably one of the best out there.
So you would think he's probably the MVP of the Forza 3 Regional Championship Series?
Definitely, for sure.
Oh, and it looks like Dejected Racer is going to catch up on Fallen 215, 2 laps to go at Mugello. Looks like they're coming up towards Turn 1, which is known as San Donato.
Looks like Dejected Racer tried it on the outside, but it didn't work.
And here they come up the ramp, and now they're going to hit Luca, which is Turn 2. On board with Dejected Racer going to Turn 3 at Poggio Seco. Now, one thing I noticed about Dejected Racer, he tries not to hit anybody on the track. He'll give you enough time to go by, and then I imagine during the last lap, it's all gloves on.
Making sure everyone stays nice and safe on the track.
I also noticed Dejected Racer has a little bit of psychological tactics, as in he'll try to go the wrong way, or... Whoa! Almost a little bit of contact there. Alright, folks, one lap to go. They're neck and neck down the straightaway.
All right. Good old drag.
So who do you think's going to get it? Dejected Racer or Fallen 215?
Looks like Dejected Racer's on the inside, so he might be taking the lead right about now.
And Fallen 215's trying to get on the inside as well at San Donato. And Dejected Racer gets a good launch right there. Going to come up on Luco. I don't think Fallen 215's going to give it up. He's trying his best to beat Dejected Racer.
Looks like Fallen's going to have to pull out some tricks to win this one.
Going to come up towards Matarazzi. On board with Dejected Racer's rear bumper. And he goes right into the gravel trap a little bit.
Looks like Fallen 215 is going to pull out this one.
Yep, here they come towards Casanova. One more turn. Can Dejected Racer do it? Nope. It looks like Fallen 215 is going to get a good launch. Checkered flag is out, and the winner at Mugello goes to
All in 2:15, Dejected Racer comes in second place. Well, that was an interesting turn of events.
Not surprised. Those two were one of the best out there.
And we got ourselves almost a close contact for third. Looks like it's going to go to X Unit. And Z85 finishes in
fourth. Well, Shib, that was a very interesting race. And looking at the final standings, Fallen 215 wins. Dejected Racer is in second. Quicksilver was in third. For a second, we thought it was X Unit. That was definitely my fault. X Unit came in fourth place. Zeta is in fifth, and last place, Netty Ice 60. So, what are your thoughts on this race?
Looks like Fallen 215 really wants to win this championship. So, Dejected Racer is going to have to fight for it this time.
And with Bugatti Circuit at Le Mans coming up, do you think it's probably going to be Fallen 215 again, or do you think it's going to be someone else in the race that's going to come home with a win?
You never know with these races, but we're going to have to watch and find out.
All right, folks, thanks for tuning in today, and looking forward to seeing you all next week at the Le Mans Bugatti Circuit. This is KRX and Shibby5777 signing off.